Dear brothers, the Te Deum has us pray, O Lord, save thy people and bless thine heritage, govern them and lift them up forever. Edward Riojas depicted this saving, blessing, governing, and lifting up of our Lord's people by drawing our eyes to our root and source, our vine, who made us his branches. At baptism, we who were dead, lifeless sticks were grafted into Jesus. Grafting requires the vine to be cut. He was sliced as the spear pierced, and the water and the blood poured out to baptize you and me into his death and resurrection, so we're alive as living branches of the vine. How do you know you're a living branch? Some would say because you bear fruit, and indeed our Lord does bear fruit through us, the joyful confession of Christ in our anxious and cynical age, the deliverance of Jesus' word, forgiveness in body and blood to fellow dying souls, and other acts of love to those we are called to serve. But a dead branch can still have fruit hanging from it too. How do I know I'm still connected to the vine, Christ Jesus? How does a branch know it's connected to its vine? It drinks in what the vine sends. So we drink what our Lord sends us, his renewing word of correction and life, and his forgiveness for our rebellion, sins, and failed love proclaimed to us by another branch called to serve us, and by receiving his body and blood, the very lifeblood of the vine, to continually supply what our souls need in this arid world. Of course, as Jesus teaches, the Father prunes us, he cleanses us, lopping off of us our false gods, our foolish passions, and our lame pride, making our life together as his church take on the shape of his cross, now the tree of life. Brothers, the Lord chose you. You didn't choose him. The Lord appointed you to bear fruit, and so you do. Apart from him, we can do nothing. But in him, he is busy bearing fruit we often cannot see, that many may eat and live. Hal, Bev, and I thank the Lord for the beautiful, rich fruit he's yielding through you, his chosen branch. Drink in Christ's joy, that in these gray, latter, and perplexing days, you daily see his redeeming love for you, his friend, and his governing and lifting up of his church and her servants. The Father of our living Lord Jesus Christ, sustain you by the Holy Spirit, causing you to flourish in bearing love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. In the holy name of Jesus.